tell us a bit about yourself and how you came into this sport.
Into netball or just sport in general? I was at school, I used to play, and then I became PE teacher, and I've continued playing right through. And I had a break when I was about 50. I gave up for a few years, and then I came back to netball, and I moved up here, because I'm actually from Essex. So I moved up here and came back to netball when I was 55.
Impressive.
Which was a few years ago now. So I've been playing ever since.
Impressive. What challenges have you faced and how have you overcome them?
Fitness, obviously, is something as you get older. And I'm not as quick as I used to be, so I get frustrated that I can't play like I used to.
Yeah.
But as long as you keep going, as I say, if you don't use it, you lose it, don't you? So.
We've heard very good things about you, so. have you found sports to help you physically and mentally?
Yeah, physically, it just keeps you going. I know lots of people who, you know, just they give up and they're not walking, and then obviously your mobility goes and all sorts of things. So
yeah.
As long as you keep active, things are going to keep going a lot longer.
Do you think it's had a benefit on you mentally? Or?
Yes, because it gets you out and gets you going, and obviously you feel much better after you've had a run around.
True. What are the benefits of being active for you?
Health-wise, I think. I'm obviously a lot healthier than I would have been if I'm not active, so.
True. And finally, what advice would you give to other women wanting to be active, to get active?
Go and do it.
Do it.
Yes, because what trouble is people, especially if it's a sport game, people do think, oh, I don't want to show myself up in front of other people and that sort of thing. So just have a go. I mean, if you come back to netball, I think they do it on a Monday night, where you just go and have a game, all levels, and you just, if you don't like it, you know, try something else.
That's good. That's all the best.